How y'all doing? Who knows what Psalms 34 says in chapter 8? Who knows? Give you a hint. Taste. And
see,
there you go.
The Lord is good.
All right. Taste and see, you got to taste and see, you got to taste and see. Father's name. Hey, does anybody out there love Jesus Christ? All right, here's some good news and some bad news. The good news is God is sovereign, and his hand is the final word. He wins the game, all that kind of thing. The bad news, well, there really isn't any bad news unless you're not on his side, all right? This song is called The Hand of God.
Come on!
so much. Anybody been blessed yet tonight?
Yeah.
All right. For a little bit of boogie blues, what do you say? Is that all right?
Yeah.
All right. You're always by my side, you always got my back, you're there for me every time I'm taking flat. You help me find my way when I lost control. Jesus, you're the lover of my soul. When I stumble and fall, you forgive me of my sin and that and all. You got a place to make when you take me home. Here we go. Jesus, you're the lover of my soul. Special guest sitting in, our founding member from over 10 years ago, Brother Brad Marsh, our guitar. Hi, brother.
Yeah.
Hey, man. Woo. You want to mix it up with me for a minute, brother? Come on. Of my stop, guys. I'm not done. I gotta try one more thing. Anybody having fun yet? All right. You guys are really good. Let me just try one thing. Indulge me here. Original thought. This is a thought that came from Glenn Kaiser, but I totally agree with him. Instruments like this, this is a picture of what God does for you and me, because a lot of the materials that went into this were scraps of junk. They were not valued by anybody in the world. They were destined for the trash bin. They're on their way to the incinerator, but they got snatched away from destruction and turned into something special and beautiful thanks to the touch of the Master's hand. Right? He sent me me a YouTube link, and he said, hey, man, there's one of these songs that I got. You might find it interesting. And I'm thinking, oh, man, somebody's put me on a spot to play their song. So I went and listened to it, and guess what? I liked it. And I played it for the guys, and they thought, hey, they liked it too. So here we go. I hope you're blessed by this. Jesus, you are Lord of all the heavens. Jesus, you are Lord of all the earth. Every knee will bow before you, Jesus. And every tongue will speak your matchless.
Artist Jessica Speck gets ready. Hey, Mark. How you doing, brother?
A little tired, but I'm doing all right. How you been?
Worked up a little sweat, didn't you?
A little bit. Well, I need my exercise. What can I say?
Man, how does it feel being back with the boys?
Well, I'll tell you what. We've had a little bit to do during the shutdown, but not that much. And, you know, we thank God that things like Red's Room was going on, and all of us everywhere learning how to do things online. It kind of was keeping us going. But you know what? There is nothing like playing in front of real human beings, and we are unbelievably grateful for every one of you who came out here. That's you. Yeah.
Big hands for the human beings.
Yeah. So, really grateful.
So, brother, I mean, you've done a number of Red's Room episodes, either you singing with them on tape, or you actually hosting. You've actually hosted.
Yeah. I hosted a few times, and nothing exploded, so I guess it went pretty good. So, yeah.
Well, brother, I mean, wow. Would you like to, if you get a chance, would I like to meet the band members?
Yeah. Hey, are the other guys, come over and say hi real quick? I know they're kind of busy tearing stuff down.
Tearing stuff down, yeah.
Right here. Come on, you guys. Hurry up. So, like I said.
I'm just the nurse, actually.
Okay. This is one of our founding members. He was our original guitarist 10 years ago, and then he moved out of the area because he had to move from San Jose back down here. So you guys are lucky to have him down here. But whenever we come down, he comes and sits in, and we're really grateful. This is Brad Marsh. Over here, brother Vince Lopez is our newest guitar guy. Say hi.
Hello.
And we are grateful. He is awesome. Bill Malari right over here. This is our drummer. The whole reason this band started is because he texted me a message one day and said, you want to start a gospel blues band? And little did he know that the answer for a long time had been, yes, that's what I've wanted to do for so long. Jim, come up and say hi. Come out. And we've got the Funk Master himself, one of the finest bass players on the planet, Brother June Lagmay. Say hi, you guys.
Hello.
¿Cómo está?
There you go.
Yeah. I don't need it.
All right. Okay.
By the way, a good segue into my Spanish Red's Room shirt.
Yeah,
Red's Room, alabando a Dios, un concierto a la vez. We've been doing that lately.
Yeah, Red's Room has been expanding. I mean, you're covering all different parts of the world. You're covering all genres, and now you're covering Espanol. It's cool.
We haven't had any penguins tune in from Antarctica yet, but we got the other continents covered. But, brother.
Somebody's got to minister to the penguins, okay?
Now, one thing I missed tonight is your harp, and that's the blues term for
a
harmonica.
Yes, our harmonica guy had a schedule conflict and couldn't make it. But you know what? Lord willing, we'll be back down here again real soon. Before the pandemic, we'd get down to Southern California roughly about twice a year. And always means so much to us because, you know, we've developed kind of a following of people who are really, they're more than fans. They become special friends, and we want to come and play for you guys.
Oh, so. I remember hanging out about a month ago just eating dinner, fellowshipping with you.
Yes, and with Buster the Wonder Dog. Yes.
I met your dog in person.
Yeah.
Yes, and I know why you love that dog so much. Yeah. Now, before you did blues, you did something else. What were you doing before that?
Well, what's that? Yeah. Oh, he's got a mic. So, you're talking about the Retro Project? So, that?
You had a different style of music, didn't you?
Well, so here's the thing. Long ago, back in my youth when dinosaurs roamed the earth, I was doing music and I didn't know about blues yet. I hadn't discovered it yet. And at the time, I didn't have the connections. I didn't have the money to get electric equipment. I didn't have connections to musicians. All I could do was sort of like acoustic, sort of, you know, Christian ballad kind of stuff. And so I did a bunch of that stuff. And it was okay, but it really kind of went nowhere. Well, and then it sat on the shelf for many years as I got busy with life. About 15 years ago, I discovered blues, and it became my obsession. And then came Christian blues, and that's what I've been doing all this time. But I wanted to go back full circle and revisit some of those old songs that sat on the shelf for a very long time, because they, you know, they were special songs and meant a lot to me. And I just didn't have the proper resources at the time to record them well. So I'm working on one more solo album. I've got a couple of solo albums, but I want to make one more, which will be called Retro. And one of the various things that will be in it is a lot of these old timeless worship tunes. Well, finally, all these years later, it's feasible to record them and make them hear sound the way I wanted them to sound. So that's what
Excellent.
I'm doing.
And I'm sure people are curious about some of these different concoctions, these guitars, and I don't even know what to call them. Some of them have three strings.
Well, one is a cigar box guitar, and can you guess why it's called that? It's made from a cigar box. The other one is simply, that's just a soup can. It's a great big soup can. And, you know, there's a couple of tricks. I put a special pickup on the inside that's kind of microphonic, so you can holler into it.
Well, that was my favorite part, when you started hollering into your guitar.
Well, actually, there's actually a secret. There's actually a little tiny man this tall inside the can.
Well, bring him out. I'd like to introduce him.
Well, yeah. Well, it gets really bad if I forget to feed him.
You know? So, I hope he doesn't have soup in the can.
Well, I remember what kind of soup was in there before. It's not that different.
Yeah, it's probably from 1980-something, so I wouldn't trust it anymore.
Yeah. And, you know, there wasn't really time tonight, but, you know, I've also got, like, this one-string thing that I play. And all of these kind of homemade things, they're all part of blues history because those were the kind of instruments where blues music was developed over the decades. Back when people were in so much poverty, they couldn't go to the music store and buy a guitar. So they would build instruments out of any kind of scraps of junk they could find. Like John Lee Hooker, when he was a boy, his first musical instrument was rubber straps nailed on the side of a barn.
Wow.
And so this is just kind of paying homage to the history of the blues, and they have such a haunting, special sound of their own.
I know when you were giving the analogy of God taking what other people might consider to be garbage, and in the master's hand and putting it together, making something beautiful, that touched my spirit in a deep way. What about you guys? Did that touch you in a deep way when you heard that? Amen.
You know,
and so that's the takeaway from tonight.
I mean, that's the good news out of the New Testament, isn't it?
It is, and that's what Jesus is expert in doing, taking what the devil has pretty much left and cast aside in the gutter and raising it up and using it. And he's done that in each of our lives, hasn't he?
That's right.
So, and I'm sure it's three Brady Cord, same thing. We all have a story, right?
Yeah.
We weren't born Christian.
Right? Well, it's part of why I love Christian blues, because it's in a real raw, human, edgy way. It's touching on that story of redemption.
Amen. And your unshaped guitar illustrates that.
Yeah.
Well, totally. Well, I appreciate you guys coming. So make sure that their swag table is emptied by the time they leave. They'll go make some more swag.
So. Yeah, by the way, you wanted me to remind you about, I got that book here finally. Remember my book?
Your book. You wrote a book, right?
I did, yes.
Tell us about your book.
Well, so I had been looking at other books that talked about the connection between the gospel and blues music, and none of those books, I just didn't like how they were written. I would sit there and not be happy. They should be saying this and this and this. And I realized, well, if somebody needs, you know, I better do it myself. So basically, I wrote a short, it's not very long, but a little book, which is just a collection of short essays about my experience and thoughts and observations as a Christian musician, immersing into blues music, touching all different things about it, how it affected me in my personal life. My very special wife, Anne, helped me to proofread it, and she happens to be very good at that kind of thing. So the prose is actually decent quality. And the thing is, I went and printed, you know, a bunch of hard copies of this book, and then the pandemic hit, and I couldn't take them anywhere. So this is actually the first time they're actually out anywhere.
All right, so let's snatch those up tonight, too. Well, we got a little glimpse of his thinking and his spiritual depth through his illustration about the guitar, so I bet you there's a lot more nuggets of wisdom in that thing. So,
yeah, or at the very least, you can decide if you agree or disagree.
Yep.
Yes.
And you'll find him on Facebook. If you disagree, hit him up and tell him.
That's right.
All right, well, let's everybody just give a big round of applause and a big thank you to Mark Jagers and the Crimson Blues.
Good luck to these guys.
Amen.
Thank you guys for letting me play in front of human beings.
Amen.